Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the combined weight of 458 pounds, the team of White Diamond, Tim Horner, and Brad Armstrong!
Brad Armstrong and Tim Horner, what's happening? For the World Tag Team Championship here. Tremendous matchup. We're happy to bring you this main event exclusively here on TBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, making their way into the ring area from Bad Street, USA, attempting to the ring by Diamond Dallas Page, the new World Tag Team Champions, the fabulous Freebirds! That's right, Diamond Dallas Page here, chairman of the board of the Diamond Exchange. You know, I'm not the kind of guy that says, I told you so. But for all you Copenhagen dipping, coupon clipping, draft beer drinking rednecks, I told you so that these gentlemen right here, the fabulous Freebirds, Jimmy Jam Garvin, Michael Pureless Sexy Hayes, would be the next World Tag Team Champion. Was I lying, Rhubarb? I told them on Y 104 and Y 106. I told the world. Well, Daddy-O, you know, Diamond Dallas Page can't
not
be all places. Between the normal,
it was my piece of there. Cake.
Between the Dynamite and Johannesburg, South Africa, I can't be all places at one time. Good God, baby. So, I brought on a road boss. A road boss to take care of the birds on the road. Break it down one time. He's talking loud. He's being proud. And he's drawing a crowd. The man that DDP pays to think. Big, daddy, big. And he's accompanied by one of the lovely Diamond Dolls.
Well, it's quite an entourage indeed. The new World Tag Team Champions have plenty of support personnel on the road, it would seem.
Almost definitely, and I'll tell you something else. My hat goes off to Big Daddy Dink. I think this guy earned the title of the greatest wrestling manager of all time, and he did it in one night and one night only.
Well, I think the fans, you know, can make their own analogy of exactly what transpired. If they watched our event last Sunday, it wasn't like it was a landslide victory for the Freebirds over Doom.
No, no, wait a second now. You're not giving credit where credit's due. Big Daddy Dink spent the past 6 months handling Bon Jovi's equipment. He comes out of retirement, comes back into wrestling, and what happens on his first night? He becomes the manager of the World Tag Team Champion.
Well, you saw the tape. You were there.
Yeah.
That's the night you were humiliated. Remember when your pants ripped out? The giant slammed you?
Yeah.
Remember that?
I also remember the fact that I had enough guts to slap Elegante across the face, something that neither you, Gordon Sully, or any other so-called
reporter
would
do. Why would we want to, you blithering fool? The thing about it is, the Freebirds were very lucky to leave there with the World Tag Team Championship. I'm not discounting their ability. There was a lot of problems that night. You know, there was some brass knucks involved, and we'll be taking a closer look at that in upcoming weeks. But in any event, this is a championship event right here on TBS, and Tim Horner and Brad Armstrong are an outstanding team.
Oh, yeah, and they would love to bring the tag team titles home to their own stomping ground. I mean, hey, this Friday, Knoxville, Tennessee. Next Saturday, Nashville, Tennessee. That's Horner and Armstrong's old stomping ground. Wouldn't they love to show up with the World Tag Team titles around their waist those nights?
Head scissor by Brad Armstrong, taking Jimmy Jam Garvin over. I can tell you one thing, Horner and Armstrong are not intimidated or impressed about the Diamond Doll, or whatever she was, the lady with the Big Daddy Dink, or the diamonds on the hand of Diamond Dallas Page. It's all well and good if you're into materialistic things, so they want to be the champion. They want to be the tag team champions of the world, and this is the title that all tag teams are shooting for.
Yeah, but you see what a night it was for the fabulous Freebirds when they regained the title, because not only did they get the belts off Doom, but the number one contenders for the titles, the ex-champions Doom, split up moments later.
Michael Hayes, very confident right now. They're really on a a mental high. They've crested as far as their career. They're at the top of their game right now, the WCW World Tag Team Champions. They, too, have signed to be on that magnificent card 1 week from tomorrow night in the Omni. Hayes with a kick to the midsection on Tim Horner, tossed outside. And Horner landed on his feet.
He's look right out behind you!
Right hands by Horner. Sending Hayes now for the trip to the middle of the ropes and elevates it. Dale Garvin there as well. Hayes is not in a very friendly confines there. He needs to get back to his own place.
Well, that's the place to be, wouldn't you say?
If you're looking for sanctuary, indeed it would be.
I still can't get over now. Why would you assign Missy Hyatt to interview Ron Simmons?
Well, apparently your memory is not very long. I told you earlier, I don't assign anything. The director does that. I'm not the director.
Well, who is?
Dan Bynum.
How do you spell that last name?
Head scissor by Tim Horner. Firmly applied there to Jimmy Jam Garvin. Our senior official, Nick Patrick, who made a real gutsy call this past Sunday night in the War Games. I know some fans may not have agreed with it. I personally thought it was the right call at the right time. He had to make that call, and he did it. And my hat's off to him. He had the intestinal fortitude to do the right thing.
Because, you see, if the peroxide didn't soak into Missy's brain, she'd ask one big question to Ron Simmons. And that's, if he begs Teddy Long and Butch Reed for forgiveness, doesn't he think that Doom, if they regroup, could get the title back from the Freebirds? Because everybody's after the Birds. I mean, the Steiners want a shot. The State Patrol wants a shot. Casey Horner and Armstrong want a shot, and they're getting it right here tonight.
Garvin out making the exchange with Michael P.S. Hayes. Hayes and Timmy Horner in there. Another collar and elbow tie-up. Hayes with the advantage. But Horner reversed that Irish whip. And up on top of Hayes, falling back in kind with some right hands. Irish whipping Hayes into the neutral corner. And there was a big-time layup and a bulldog. That may finish Horner off right there.
Here
Hayes
we go.
On top. One, two, and Horner kicked out.
Now, what kind of defense can anybody have for that? I mean, out of nowhere comes that left hand. Hey, I've said it before, I'll say it again. If this guy ever went into boxing, Evander Holyfield would lose the title to him in three rounds.
Hayes, that reverse chin lock. Got it locked in. Look over the shoulder of Big Daddy Dink, the new road boss of the World Tag Team Champions, the fabulous Freebirds. Diamond Dallas Page very involved in his diamond mines, traveling extensively. Can't be at, as he said, all places at one time. Hayes missed with that clothesline. Garvin from behind there, getting the attention of Tim Horner. Now Garvin comes in. He'd be able to face him face to face.
And it was a classic mistake by Tim Horner. He turned his back on his opponent, and you can never turn your back on the Birds.
Lateral press and two. You know, I think when Garvin got the championship belts this past Sunday, got his hand raised, for the fans that saw it, I think you would agree. I don't think he even realized that he had won the title.
Well, he was in such a state of euphoria that he couldn't even believe it. I mean, it was a dream come true. And then...
Oh, he was dreaming all right. He was dreaming. Brad Armstrong comes in. Armstrong sending Garvin up and over. Great right hand by Brad. Tremendous competitor from Marietta, Georgia, where we'll be this Tuesday night. Hayes scooped up. Armstrong really on fire here, ramming the champions' heads together.
The Birds are in trouble right here.
Remember, this one is for the World Tag Team Championship. Garvin raked the eyes. It's Horner on the advantage here. He's got him rolled up for the pin. And Hayes comes in, and Hayes with a DDT. The referee was putting Tim Horner out. He did not see the illegal man with a DDT.
The winners of the match, the fabulous Freebirds!
Well, the Freebirds with a DDT, that is their equalizer, and so is this left hand.
Here you see the most awesome 1-2 punch in World Championship Wrestling. The left hand followed up by a running bulldog by Michael P.S. Hayes. And then the reason why they are not only the greatest rock and roll band of all time, but also the master of the double team tactics and the new World Tag Team Champions, the illegal DDT, but an effective one, Jimmy Jam and Michael P.S. are your champions.
When we come back, Missy Hyatt will be talking to Ron Simmons. That interview is next on TBS.